This line tells a story. The story changes depending on whether the line climbs up, plateaus, or the line goes down. What do the lines created by COVID-19 data tell us?
The best thing to do is look at the local data because things are varying quite a bit, not only country to country, but state to state. And even within different counties, there's rapidly different spread depending on what's going on in your community. So it's helpful to look at different things together, including cases, hospitalizations, and deaths. A lot of these metrics vary based on who's reporting it, and they're reporting them in slightly different ways. The number of confirmed cases is likely lower than the number of actual cases because not everyone has been tested, and a lot of the milder or asymptomatic cases were likely missed, especially earlier on in the pandemic.
States have different ways of keeping track of how many people are in the hospital being treated for COVID-19. Some states don't report this, and the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention doesn't require it.
You'll have people reporting the number of people currently hospitalized for COVID, the total number over time, who's in the intensive care unit, and then some states also give you age and underlying health condition data and other demographics such as race and ethnicity, though that's not uniform across everywhere. So the hospitalization data that you're gonna find depends a lot on where you are. States and counties also have slightly different methods for counting deaths, but it's one of the more solid data points that we have to actually figure out how far and how severely the disease is spread. But like the number of confirmed cases, the number of COVID deaths is also likely higher, especially since we didn't test a lot of people sort of in the beginning of the pandemic.
Some states are going back and counting deaths presumed to be from COVID-19. That may skew the trend.
Sometimes what you'll see is a spike in deaths in some states. That recently happened in New Jersey when there was a spike, but actually they just went back and added a lot of their presumed deaths to their total death count.
There is a metric lag between the data points, confirmed cases, hospitalizations, and deaths.
First, as people start to show symptoms and get tested, you'll likely see cases, followed a week or so by hospitalizations. And then deaths usually lag behind those because usually with this disease, people are sick for a few weeks before they die.
Public health authorities also track the positivity rate. That compares the number of tests that come back positive with the total number of COVID-19 tests.
So if positivity rate is high, that likely means that all of the cases in the area aren't necessarily being caught. But if the positivity rate is low, most of the cases are likely being captured and you're probably doing enough testing to capture all of the cases. But keeping track of how the positivity rate is changing now that there is wider spread testing is important. Because if the positivity rate is going up over time in a specific area, that likely means that there are more cases being found and the disease is spreading. Sometimes there are spikes or ebbs or different patterns. Like for instance, case and death reporting usually slows down on the weekends. And so it's important to look at averages, whether or not it's over 5 days or 7 days, to sort of smooth out all of those lags and look at the trends over time. Because looking at just one day or just the last couple of days likely isn't going to give you a clear picture.